So after all of that hard work of getting that song back, I thought maybe you'd want to understand why it was so important to maintain that. So the tool that was used to create it was something called Audiomaster IV. And what really makes this just crazy unique is how they made that song. Now, today you could load Audacity or just about any other audio program, and you could clip together a series of clips to create a remix of a song. I mean, we do it all the time. But now, back in 1990, 1991, this was how you had to do audio sequencing. So what these guys did is they used this tool, and they would sample using a digital sampler. They would record both songs, You Can't Touch This and Super Freak. They recorded them both and loaded both of those songs side by side into this waveform editor. Then what they would do is they would take sequences of the song clips, and they would try to reuse the same ones over and over and over again, because most songs are constructed that way, of repetition. So by setting an in point and an end point and then adding it to the sequence, they could easily resequence a huge waveform of music into something very, very small. And so they would do that until they had the full song done. Let's take a look.
Can't touch this. Can't touch this.
So they just repeated it once, and then they're going to jump ahead and play a little bit more.
Can't touch
And
this.
they're going to play a little bit, and you can see as you're playing this thing back exactly what it is it took for them to do this. And obviously that there are pieces of the song that are unique that you can't necessarily use out of turn. So they'll record, you can see they use that whole big giant clip here. But for the most part, these two songs use very, very similar clips to remake the entire song. And these can get pretty sketchy in terms of how close you have to be to make this sound perfect. Look at this. So now we're resequencing, we're jumping ahead. Okay, so we're still sort of sequential here, so it doesn't seem like anything's like super impressive here. But look at this. Now they're starting to jump back and forth and back and forth and back and forth to seamlessly replay that song, or to play this mix, if you will. And then what was great is once they did all of this sequencing and they tried to reuse these same clips over and over again, once they were done with that, then this software was so smart that it could go through the entire waveform and say, you know what? You didn't touch this whole big section right here. We're going to clip it out. And so the process was, once you've sequenced everything, you could then just say, I don't know if they called it compress or whatever, but they had a term for it. And then all of the data that you didn't use, all of the audio waveform you didn't use would be dropped. And the more clever you were, and the better off you were reusing the same clips over and over again, the smaller the file would be. Because you've, see, look at this. Now we're going to jump all over the place. Look at this. Little clip, little clip, little clip. But the goal, right? The goal was to get this on a floppy disk. 880 kilobytes is all they had. So if you wanted to share this song with your friend when you were done, you had to get it under 880 kilobytes. Now you're talking about a full 3.5 minute song that needs to fit in under 1 megabyte. Now, granted, it's mono. It's 8-bit audio sampled with one channel. But to resequence all of this and have it fit into the final file size, which in this case was 443 kilobytes, less than one half of a megabyte. Unbelievable. And then this tool also let you actually export it to a self-playing disk. And I don't know where that was. I was looking for it in here, but I couldn't find it. Strip dead space. That was what the other thing was for under sequence. But this was a remarkable tool, and the fact that that song is a piece of this history was very, very important to me to keep a hold of it and preserve it. So now at least I've got it on video how it worked, and I can share that with others. I hope you enjoyed looking at it, and thanks for following me on my adventure.